We love getting pictures from viewers on the uLocal section of our website, and one particular picture caught our attention recently. When we saw an ice tower big enough to climb in Westminster, we just had to check it out. 11 News reporter Jennifer Franciotti did just that.
Ed Balick and his 16-year-old son Mark are getting ready to go ice climbing. Not in the snowy Colorado mountains, but right here in Westminster in their very own front yard. The ice sculpture, or ice tree as they call it, is really something to see. It certainly caught our attention when Ed sent in pictures to uLocal on our website.
There's two of them up on your uLocal site.
This is a yearly ice growing project, and it started because I was an ice climber, and the idea was to try to make some ice close to home. There's a structure underneath, sort of like a rigging, like a flagpole, and various objects stuck in there to give it some shape. Otherwise, it would just be a skinny little pole. And the up on top, there's shower heads or nozzles, garden sprinkler nozzles. And it's rigged to hosing to the house.
Ed says there's a fair amount of science involved. Factors like the weather and the amount of water that comes out of the top really make a difference on how the glacier looks from day to day.
In one night, with the water too heavy, I can melt out a side of it.
Kick it in.
And while building it is fun,
climbing up's the fun part, best, I think.
Mark and his dad have been making the sculpture since he was a kid, and he says it's a pretty cool thing for the two of them to do together.
Other people do the normal, like, sports and stuff, and I ice climb with my dad and make ice trees in my front yard.
With proper tweaking and the right temperatures, Mark and Ed say they can keep this going through March. And if you have an interesting picture, submit it to uLocal. You never know, we might come visit you. In Carroll County, Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.